On February 19th, Clash of Clans released a Q&A post where they discussed their most controversial questions, and within the list of 29 questions, number 11 piqued my interest. Is the new Town Hall update schedule now 12 months instead of the roughly 18 months? And Supercell responded with yes. This means that Clash of Clans will release a new Town Hall every single year. Let me put this into perspective for you. A new Town Hall adds a whole new level to the game, with a new troop, possible new buildings, new upgrades for certain buildings, new features, new pets, new defense mechanisms, and maybe even a new hero. But will this all be too much for players? That's the question that has been at the forefront of many people's minds. But in order to answer this, we have to go back. Way back to August 2nd, 2012, where a small Finnish company released a strategy idle game to the public, and unbeknownst to them, the game blew up immediately.
Yo, what's up, you guys? It's the Godson, and it's time to get this new update content, y'all.
I'm at your Beaker's lab. First off today, I'm going to congratulate myself for maxing my goal.
What is up, guys? Kudosloth here, and welcome to this series of my final.
You guessed it, it's Galadon again from the Clan Lost Phoenix, bringing you episode 15 in the Clash of Clans attack series.
When the game was first introduced, Town Halls 1 to 8 were incorporated. They brought a lot of fun and joy to players, even though the game was at early stages to what it is today. However, after almost 3 months of the game's release, the Clash team knew that they had to introduce a new Town Hall, as players were getting maxed much sooner, and the game was starting to feel dry. Enter Town Hall 9. Town Hall 9 served as a stepping stone for the Town Halls that were to come, but it was a big jump that players did not expect. It was, and still is to this day, one of the coolest Town Hall designs that players have ever seen. However, this was Clash of Clans, and as the time progressed, players started to max their Town Halls and wanted new content. As you've guessed, Town Hall 10 was introduced. Note, this was still the early ages of the game. So, Town Halls were being introduced left, right, and center to establish a foundation for the game. Town Hall 10 was released on May 23rd, 2013, more than a year since the release of the game. Fast forwarding a little bit here, Town Hall 11 was introduced almost 2 years and a half after Town Hall 10, being the biggest break between any Town Hall release, and it was rightfully so, as the team was focusing on the introduction of the builder base as well as the expansion of Supercell, the team. Town Hall 12 came after another lengthy 2.5 year wait. Following that, Town Hall 13 released December 9th, 2019, almost 546 days after the release of Town Hall 12. And shortly afterwards, Town Hall 14 was introduced after 490 days. Town Hall 15 and 16 were also pretty rampant. Town Hall 15 was released on October 10th, 2022. And Town Hall 16 was released almost 18 months later on December 12th, 2023. It is without a doubt that this Town Hall update is getting very rampant. Town Halls are starting to lose their hype value as there are so many of them. I recall in the old days of Town Hall 10, when Town Hall 11 or Town Hall 12 was being released to the community, everybody was hyped as they haven't seen a Town Hall in ages. But with the rampant schedule being introduced in 2024, Town Halls are feeling as though they are a daily occurrence and will be arriving within a year, so they are losing their sentimental value. Especially since each one going forward will have another crazier feature that, let's be honest, most players will never be able to reach. And when or if they do manage to reach that specific Town Hall level, the hype will have already died down. This leads to another big question surrounding this yearly release of Town Halls. How will this impact new or mid-level players? I mean, it's definitely understandable that the pro league players or the spenders on the game would love a new Town Hall as fast as possible, with new content that they can test out or new troops whenever they would like. But a new Town Hall every single year is a big step in the wrong direction, especially when considering new players or the majority of mid-class players. A Town Hall distribution stat shows that the majority of players are in the Town Hall 12 to Town Hall 13 range, being equal to all of the Town Hall 1 to 8 player group. This goes to show that this community will definitely be left out of this update cycle. Players who are in the slow, progressive, and very lengthy town halls will just keep slaving away upgrade after upgrade, and inevitably they will most likely never be able to reach a maximum town hall level, as a new town hall will be coming out every year. That is to say that the majority of players who choose not to spend money on offers or the gold pass. This doesn't even go over how overwhelmed new players must feel if they boot up Clash of Clans for the first time and realize that their favorite creators or their friends are actually 16 town halls ahead of them, and to reach their level they have to wait several years. I understand that's pretty much the point of an idle game, that's what Clash of Clans is. But as of 2024, Gen Alpha and Gen Z are known to have some of the lowest attention spans ever. Which poses the question, what can Supercell do to avoid this issue, if there is anything at all? At the current time of writing this video, there are not many solutions, other than, of course, Supercell revoking their statement and changing the Town Hall update schedule. However, the only one that Supercell is actually implementing, and I have also thought of as well, is lowering the Town Hall time and cost requirements for each previous Town Hall with a new update. Which I suppose, from a general player's perspective, can actually work very well. I mean, if Clash of Clans aims for, let's say, an average player to spend a little to max out a new account in 3 to 4 years, then they will do so by adjusting the time requirements accordingly. However, is this a permanent solution? And the short answer is no. I mean, how far can this keep going? If Clash of Clans has implemented a new town hall every single year, that means 10 years down the road, will there be 10 times the town hall time reductions? That just won't make any sense. Town halls won't feel as rewarding, and as talked about, they will be losing their sentimental value, especially if players are getting through them within a few weeks. So, what are the proposed solutions? What can Clash of Clans do to combat such issue? Well, this is where you guys come in. So far, I couldn't think of much, of course, other than time reductions. Please leave your suggestions to this problem in the comments below, or feel free to tackle this on the Clash of Clans Reddit. At the end of the day, Clash of Clans might always find this cycle overwhelming and pull back their 1 year statement. You never know what the future of Clash of Clans may look like, but it is for sure guaranteed that if Clash of Clans were to go down this path of New Year, New Town Hall, it would for sure not end well for the company. Please let me know your thoughts and suggestions about this down below. YouTube thinks you'll like these videos next. Peace out and take care.